Sri Manish Sisodia. We're still waiting, I think, for the Health Minister, Sri Shatindra, and Principal Mr. D.K. Bedi, distinguished guests, staff, students, and parents. On behalf of the APJ Education Society, I would like to extend a very warm welcome to all of you for the APJ Award. I would also like to take this opportunity to thank our chief guest, Sri Manish Sisodia, and the guest of honor, which I think should be coming soon, Sri Satyendra Jain, and all distinguished guests for sparing their valuable time to be a part of this important initiative. It is indeed an honor to have you all here today. For close to 5 decades since its inception in 1967, the APJ Education Society has been at the forefront of its vision of man-making and nation-building. Strengthening the national fabric is at the core of the vision. All APJ institutions are involved in various community upliftment programs which are incorporated in the school curriculum. Every member of APJ is groomed to serve the community before self. To the values set by my beloved grandfather, late Dr. Satya Paul, and has been carried forward by my mother, Mrs. Sushma Paul Berdia, President APJ Education Society. The synergy of students and staff to maintain the pride of the city Delhi is by making it pollution free is yet another humble contribution towards APJ's commitment to nation building. Delhi, the national capital city, is a vibrant cosmopolitan which attracts visitors from all over the world and is considered one of the leading cities in terms of business, culture, history, and heritage. I congratulate the gracious members of the government present here with us today for their pioneering efforts in upholding the pride of the capital city through their innovative initiatives. By 2020, India is set to become the world's youngest country with 64% of its population in the working age group. But today, one of the major threats for the welfare of youthful population is pollution of various types, and it plagues the health for all of us. The resounding success of the recent odd-even rule of vehicles to curb congestion and air pollution initiated by the Delhi government under able leadership of Delhi Chief Minister Sri Arvind Kejriwal and Sri Manish Sisodia was an encouraging step. It was the first such path-breaking initiative in the country, and it was heartening to see the overwhelming response that it got from citizens of Delhi who came forward in full support to make the odd-even scheme a successful endeavor. I would like to say that it is a duty of each and every citizen to think in a broader perspective to control the evil of pollution. All our resources and wealth will be of no value if we cannot afford a healthy environment for our future generations. Let us all take a pledge to do whatever we can for our environment and to protect it the best we can. I would once again like to express our gratitude towards Sri Manish Sisodia and Mr. Satyendra Jain for their presence and further heightening the motivation of students present here. I heartily thank them for their valuable contribution in inspiring the young students. I would like to end by the famous words of a Chinese philosopher, Liao Zi. The journey of 1,000 miles begins with one step. So let us be the first to take the step to end pollution. Thank you very much.